Betty. Welcome to our Mother's Day table. Now we'll start here at the head of the table, and I'll show you just kind of in general what people are getting as standard, and from there on they can choose what they want, and they don't have to eat this anyway. Let's start with the drinks. I have iced tea for everybody. I have iced water. I have a cup of coffee, and here is a specialty drink. It is something that is called strawberry sherbet fizz. So if you want to look that up, it only has three ingredients. It's non-alcoholic, although you could exchange the liquid in there for champagne and have an alcoholic beverage. Coming on to the plate here, we have our soup. This is cream of pimento soup, and you'll see that as we go down the line. Right here, I have some bread for this place setting, and this is chia seed muffin. Along with that, I have a little pat of butter for this person, and this is for the whole table, which will be replenished if needed, and a butter spreader for that. Over here, for this person, I decided to put their soup, their bread, and their salad. So this is a beet romaine salad. And it has a vinaigrette dressing, which is balsamic vinaigrette. So that's just wonderful. You may see that in just a minute too. This is the whole batch of chia seed muffins. That's where the bread is coming from. And this is the pimento soup, cream of pimento soup, with one serving taken out. So it makes a little bit more than that. The beet salad, beet and romaine lettuce salad, has a lot of other ingredients. It's really colorful, brilliant, and it's very healthy. It has a balsamic vinaigrette, and you'll need to stir that together really well before you pour it over any individual serving. Next, we have creamed spinach. And on top of this, to dress it up a little bit, is some grated Parmesan cheese, and also some toasted pine nuts. That makes it really extra special. Here we have noodles Romanoff, and those are a great dish to have instead of mashed potatoes or macaroni and cheese or your normal starch. But this is topped with flat leaf parsley, and that makes a pretty addition to the table as well as very tasty. Now our main course or entree is grilled ham. This is grilled ham steak, and I grilled it in the oven because it's still cold here and we don't really want to go outside and use the outdoor grill yet, but we'll be doing that a lot during the summer. So this is really a nice tasting steak because it's marinated overnight and gets a lot of good flavors absorbed into it. And next to this, I'm kind of getting into some sweet stuff. What I have is rice pudding. This is creamy rice pudding. I called it Kentucky rice pudding. I did decide to put some toasted almonds and also some dried fruit. Those are dried blueberries and dried cherries, and they puff up. This is a refrigerated dessert or a side dish, whichever one you want to think of it. Next, I have chocolate cashew scones. I've made a couple of scone recipes in Betty's Kitchen recently. This one is my favorite. It's almost like having rich chocolate brownies, but it does have the characteristics of the scone. Next, we're into our desserts. This is traditional Southern Congo squares. So it's, I thought, children and kids like to have something that's more of a cookie or a bar cookie than perhaps a scone, and not so much as a cake or pie. So that's mainly for the kids, but adults enjoy it as well. And then I think the last thing I have in my lineup here is the chocolate mousse cake. So that's my finale. It is wonderful, I'll have to say. Let me lift it up a little bit. You can see the inside here, it is scrumptious, and it's really easy to make. I did try very hard to put together a sampling of dishes that you would find easy to make if you wanted to use them for Mother's Day. They don't necessarily form a menu as such, although I did try to get entree, salad, soup, side dishes, desserts, and so on. But if you just look at one thing on here and think, oh, I can use that in my meal, then I'm happy. I feel like I've done my job. But if you want to try to copy it all, feel free. It's not that much trouble because each dish in itself is fairly simple, except maybe one or two. And that would be probably the chocolate mousse cake, which really wasn't that hard. I'm looking for something that was hard. There was nothing that was really that hard. So I hope you enjoy this little tour around the table. And I'd like to say Happy Mother's Day to all of you out there. And Rick, do you want to wish Mother's Day?
Happy Mom Day.
And we hope you enjoy this video.